Well, we stopped by Bucky's here to get us some gas, something to eat, and then get back on the road. Now we're inside Bucky's here. It's all kinds of stuff in here, you know. We all probably know about Bucky's. We've got a lot of stuff. We're just walking through, kind of getting you a little taste of it. Seeing things I don't even think I've ever seen here before. A lot of little things here, and clothes and toys and all kinds of stuff. This is what you do when you go on a trip. You got to stop at places. Look at here. Mr. Bucky. Hello, Bucky. Bucky. This is what you have to do when you go on a trip. You've got to stop and pick up stuff. You've got to stop. Look at here. Look at that keychain right here. Bucky's keychain. Bucky's lapel pin. Look at that. All kinds of goodies here for the Bucky fan. I like Bucky stores. This is the one down here in Warner Robins, down 75 South here in our good old home state of Georgia. Oh, here's the Bucky man. Oh, hello, my name is Bucky.
Hi, I am a Bucky man. I am a Bucky. Ah, I am a Bucky.
Look at that gigantic Bucky right here. Look at him. Hello there, Mr. Bucky. How are you today? We got this truck here too. Look at this truck, this old truck, man. It's really cool, really cool. I hope you can hear me talking. I don't have a microphone on this thing yet. Here's inside the truck. There's another Bucky driving. Look at him. Honk, honk.
Hello, my name is Bucky and I'm driving the old Ford truck.
It's not very crowded in here tonight because we're here on a Wednesday night. And when we've been in here on a Saturday or a Sunday heading on our trip, this place is so packed you can't hardly move. Trust me, you cannot hardly move in here. I am enjoying this very much so tonight. This is incredible. Look here, they have their own beef jerky. Their own beef jerky here. Yeah. This is Bucky's. This is what it's all about, people. This is what it's all about. You gotta stop at Bucky's when you go on a trip. You gotta stop at Bucky's when you go on a trip. Look at these little pieces of meat here. Turkey tenders. They've got so much stuff in here, it's unreal. If you've never seen a Bucky's or been to a Bucky's, you need to go. Here's right there. This is a computer screen. You go on here and you can order stuff from here. All kinds of food that you can order here from that place. And you've got the candy. You've got the snacks, the fudge. You've got the fudge here. You got the fudge there. Here a fudge, there a fudge. Everywhere a fudge fudge. Yeah, I know. That's a little silly, ain't it? Look at here. You got stuff over here. These are those beaver chips. It's like they're homemade potato chips. They're good. I've had them before. I might get some tonight. Not sure. And then you have the famous barbecue sandwiches, the pork, the beef brisket. I've had the beef brisket, but I think I like the pulled pork sandwich better. Yeah, the pulled pork sandwiches are better than the beef brisket, in my opinion. Then you got the big biscuit sandwich.
Look at this bass.
You've got all this stuff here. It's just jam-packed full of stuff, people. Just jam-packed. There's the famous beaver nuggets. I've never had those. I think they're like corn nuggets or something. Corn chip nuggets. I've never had them. I'm not sure if I'm going to get one or not. I'll tell you what I do like. I like to get those chocolate-covered almonds. They're right over there. Right over there. I'll be going over there momentarily. But I'm just looking around right now and giving y'all a little taste of what Bucky's looks like when it's not hardly crowded. And so, here we go. What did you find?
Things that I need.
Okay, good. All right, well, I'm gonna sign off here for now and take care of some business. And go ahead and get me some chocolate-covered almonds and get a little snack for supper, and we're gonna get on the road. and we'll be showing you a little bit more later. So here's where we stayed at last night on our adventurous journey. This is the Wingate by Wyndham. It's in Valdosta, Georgia. The exit number, I think, is 22, not sure. But I know the name of the road is St. Augustine Drive. And it's tucked away down behind other buildings. And right over there behind that big magnolia tree and oak tree is the highway. But it's quiet inside there. And it's a nice place to stay. We've stayed here several times. And when we have our trips down to Disney, sometimes we'll drive all the way down. Sometimes we'll drive all the way down from our hometown area, and sometimes we won't. Now, if you look right up there at those two windows at the top, the one on the left and the one on the right, that's where our room was last night, facing the front of this hotel. The room on the right, the window on the right, I should say, is the living room. And the room on the left with the windows is the bedroom. And that's where I slept last night. It's a nice place. It's just your typical little hotel kind of a place. But it's a nice place to stay. They have a free breakfast, which is very good. They had scrambled eggs, which was excellent. I don't know how they fix them, but they tasted really good. And they had grits and gravy, biscuits, bacon, pastries, muffins, waffles, whatever you wanted, really. The only thing they didn't have that I really would like to have is hash browns. But that's all right. That's not a problem. But just in our journey, and it's early morning right now, about 8 o'clock, I'd say. And we're about to check out of the hotel and then get back on the highway and head on down to Florida. So in about maybe half an hour, we shall come into the Florida Visitor Center, and we'll stop and get off there and take a break and video a little bit more in our adventurous journeys heading to Disney. We made it to the Florida Visitor Center here. And we're going to get inside and kind of take a little quick look. And we're also going to get us some orange juice.
Orange juice.
And then there's juice.
There you go.
All right. Let's get over here. Can I get orange juice, please?
There you go.
Appreciate it.
You're welcome. Welcome to Florida, orange grapefruit.
We're going to try this orange juice here.
There you go.
Fresh squeezed orange juice. Let's see how it is. That's good orange juice. All right. That's going to do it for this segment. And we're going to get this on the road and head on down. And in about 2.5-3 hours, we'll be down at Disney World. And we'll see you when we get there. Well, we made it. We're now at Disney Springs, and we're walking around, just got here. And so we're gonna go and find something to eat for lunch.
Can we talk about this?
So as we're walking and looking, it's a little bit crowded today, it seems like. Weather feels pretty good. Sunny.
Honestly, I would put mine in quite thing.
Sunny. A little bit of a crowd, not too bad, but we're going to go ahead and go eat. We're probably going to go to Polite Pig and eat there. So that's probably what we'll do, is eat here at Polite Pig. Hello everyone, we are finally here at Disney Springs and we're eating lunch, and I'm having the loaded frites, have you say that, from the poutine place. They're so good.
It's quick, didn't take long to get it. Not very expensive for Disney prices, and they're very good. A little bit windy out here today. A little cool. I've still just got on a t-shirt. I don't have a jacket on, but it's not bad. But this food's good. I always drink water, save a few dollars. Plus, you never can drink too much water. Here's the food. Looks good. It really is good.
I like to collect the stuff like this. I collect stuff like the this Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway car that you ride in. I don't have that one yet, and I don't have the pirate thing yet. There was a little bit plastic and they're kind of flimsy. Not crazy about them. I was down here in October, I bought this one of the People Mover. I like it, I got that. But look at here. Here's a new something they've come out with since we were down here in October. And it is the Doom Buggy in the Haunted Mansion. So I think I'm gonna get this one because I like to collect these types of things that are the little ride vehicles. So I guess that's what I'm trying to say, the ride vehicles. Here's the monorail in a box. I'll turn it around there so you can see it. See, there's a monorail. I bought that years ago. I've got that. And then here's the tram. I've got that. I bought that 2 or 3 years ago. So that's what I like to collect in some of the cases here. Now over here, there is the a little bus of some sort. I've got two of those. I bought one trip and didn't remember that I had bought one, so I bought another one. And then when we were down here in October, I bought these, the 50th anniversary buses. I like to collect those things, the die-cast. I already have this. I've got that set. And I've got a Skyliner. I've got that. I don't have this big monorail, this radio control. I don't think I'm going to get that. I'm not too keen about that. But I'm going to get that Hatbox Ghost Doom Buggy that's right here. And I'm just going to pull one out at random and take it because that's what I want. And those are $10. So for it to be all plastic of some sort, you know, that's kind of high, but it's Disney, and of course they're going to make sure they get their big profit out of it, but that's quite all right. But anyway, you have to just love it. You just have to love Disney. You have to love wanting to be here. But it's somewhat crowded, but it ain't as bad today as it normally would be during a time of the year when it was packed. Now here's a model of some sort of the one of the cruise ships. What one is that? I'm not exactly sure. But that's a Disney cruise ship right there.
Oh, this is
and
like
here's a Pirates of the Caribbean. A little light up thing.
Oh, it's excavation.
For the kids.
No.
And you can see that pretty much, if you've been in here, you know how it looks. But this is the way the store looks and what have you. Of course, here's all these board games that they have that and puzzles, which I like to put puzzles together, but I'm holding off on buying those. But they've got a lot of these games here, and they've got puzzles and things, and they're just, oh, look at here. There's a nice drawing painting of Mickey. So, if we just kind of look at that, you can see it's painted on canvas and it's done in the black and white mode. Here's the game, Walt Disney World, Magic Kingdom. And there's Life down there in a Disney format. And here's Life up here, the display
of how it looks if you open it up and play it.
Got a lot of different merch here. Here's Monopoly in the Disney theme, Candyland in the Disney theme, Battleship. Now, I grew up playing Battleship from back in the 60s and early 70s, and I'm telling you, it didn't look anything like that. There's Perfection, and then there's It's a Small World board game. So Disney's really contracted out these board game manufacturers to put some Disney versions out, which is okay. It's okay with me. And I just think it's pretty cool. I'm not necessarily going to buy all of them, but I just think they're kind of cool to have if you like that. But as we just venture on a little bit, we're going to look through here, and here's some of the 50th anniversary of Disney merch. And here's the display, and you see all of those little sparkly star things hanging up there in the ceiling. And the 50th merch, there's some spirit jerseys there. That's a small one there. It looks to me like it would be for a child. Looks like it's a small children's one. And let's see here. Here's some metal glasses for mugs. $45 with the 50th anniversary on it. And here we have a World's Most Magical Celebration Epcot, nice emblem here, display. And here's a spirit jersey, which looks like it's an adult spirit jersey. And it looks like it might be $85, so it's a little bit out of my price range, but there's some people that's gonna pay it, and that's okay. It doesn't have to be me. And here's some pretty cool little figurines of the 50th. Let's see. They're $13. And it's got a bunch of them in here. So I think it's pretty cool, but I don't think it's anything I want to collect. There's some here that looks really cool. Now over here, we've got the 50th anniversary truck. I've got one, not of that style. I've got a 2022 or 2021. I can't remember which one I have. Now what do we have here? Is this something new? It looks like a train car. This is a train car. For $149. That's a little bit out of my league. I don't think I'm going down that rabbit hole. Oh, we got over here, we've got the little Disney Railroad. And then we've got some 50th anniversary of Mickey and Walt statue as a puzzle, 1,000 pieces. Also, we have some Joffrey's coffee blend, anniversary blend, some chocolate bars, all kinds of 50th anniversary stuff. If that's up your alley of things that you like, of what you want to buy. I don't really buy a whole lot of that stuff. Certain things I do. Like I said, the little buses that I bought last October, that's about what I buy. And then here's some more spirit jerseys, 50th anniversary. Oh, actually, those are hoodies. Those are hoodies there, so. Anyway. Now here's, I already have this little coloring book here. I color with colored pencils every now and then. And this is a coloring book that, let me see if I can show you some pictures in there a little bit. See, it's just Disney pictures. It's kind of hard to hold this gimbal cam with my phone on it and then open up stuff. So, but anyway, I'm gonna end it right here for now, and then we're going to pick back up soon. So I'll see you again in a moment. just got to the Polynesian here. I'm about to go in and look around, see if I can get some of that Walt's 1958 chili that they have at Captain Cook's. I'm hoping I can get it. Look over there, at the fire going there. There's the side of the buildings. Look at that. I wish y'all could smell what I'm smelling right now. I don't know what they're cooking or where it's at. Probably at Ohana's or one of those restaurants, but my goodness, it smells so good. And there we are heading into the Poly. And there's the monorail up there. The monorail. It's pretty sunny out here right now. And there's the monorail. Such a lovely sight to see. The vegetation, the greenery, the water, and even the fire burning. It's just such a lovely sight. It makes you feel like you're really right there in the Polynesian Islands. And then here's the other side. It's just beautiful. I just love the shrimp, the greenery, and the water, and it's just so peaceful sounding. And there's another fire, this thing's burning. Just gives it good ambience. Well, let's go inside and see what's going on inside the Poly. The last time I was down here in the Poly was back in October. So, I gotta get my poly time in. So let's go inside and see what we can find. I'm gonna go try to see if I can find that. I know where Captain Cook's is, but I'm gonna see if they have that Walt's 1958 chili. See if I can get over and try some of that. One of the guys that I watch on YouTube, one of the bloggers down here, he has gotten that several times and says it's really good. So we're going to get over here and try that out and see how good it is, actually is. This is the boutique Tiki. This is the store here in the Poly, the gift shop. I'm not going to go in there, at least not right now. And as we all know, the bubble ball's hanging. It looks like they've got a new store up there on the other side on the top called Moana Mercantile. We'll have to go up there and check that out. But first, let's go see if we can get some Walt's 1958 chili at Captain Cook's. Just a nice display. I haven't had the opportunity to stay here at this resort at this point, but I sure would love to. And I know this is one of the first original resorts that was here in 1971 when Magic Kingdom first opened. And it's an older resort, but it's still well maintained and a very beautiful resort to be in. There's a beautiful tapestry hanging up on the wall there. And so it's just a really nice little place here. The vibe is very cool in this place. So let's go in here and see what we can find as far as that chili goes. Hello, Minnie.
Oh, hello there.
That's Minnie Mouse. Here's Captain Cook's. I've eaten here before. It's very nice, very good. So here we go. Let's see if we can get that chili. I'm about to try the Walt's favorite 1958 chili. We're gonna dig into this and see how it tastes. Looks good. Got some cheese on it. See if we can figure this out. There you go. I didn't want to stop the phone just to do that. So here we go. We're gonna try it without crackers first.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Let me get this camera around here. You know, I'm still battling trying to figure this thing out here. Yeah, that's pretty good. Pretty good chili. It's got a little bite to it in the back of the throat. That's good chili. Yep, that's good chili. Got a little bit of crackers with it. We're gonna try that. Hmm. Yeah, that's pretty good chili. I just got water. 99% of the time I drink water because it's free and you don't keep drinking a bunch of stuff you don't really need that much of. I highly recommend to come here and get this. It's really good. If you like chili, you'll enjoy this. It's not spicy hot. It's just got something in it that after you swallow it, you get a little bit, just a little bite, a little bit of in the back of the throat. And it's not anything bad. It's just not, it's not hot at all. I gotta eat some more chili. Mmm. This is so good. So good. They gave me 2 packs of soda crackers. Saltines. Here in the South, we say sody. Sody crackers. At least that's what I was raised up here in my parents and grandparents saying, sody crackers. You know, it's like a short way of saying sodium crackers, which is another word for salt. But they're really called saltines. And I heard one of the bloggers I watched, he had said that Walt Disney used to keep a sleeve of saltine crackers in his jacket pocket. So when he got hungry, he'd just pull out and eat some. I guess that way he kept going and doing what he was doing, trying to get things done for the Disney company, for Disneyland, for Walt Disney World when he was down here walking the grounds before 1966, before he passed away. All right, well, I'm gonna end it right here on this little portion and see what I can do. Be back with you soon. Hello everyone, once again here, the coolest dad, Daryl here, in this little adventurous journey here at Disney Springs while my daughter is on her travel agent trip, her first one as a travel agent. But I'm sitting here right beside Amorette's, and this is my 3 days by myself. I may meet up with her and her roommate at some point, maybe tomorrow, maybe they'll be over at Epcot or somewhere, I'm not sure. But anyway, I'm just gonna get started and wanted to let y'all know that I'm here and just gonna continue with this adventure. And let's see where it takes us and what we can find. So y'all come on and hang on tight. I'm now over here at the TTC, the Ticket and Transportation Center, and I just got off of the monorail coming from the Contemporary. And now I'm about to get over on the monorail and ride over and just take one way over to Epcot. Take a look and see how some of the construction is going on as we go around Spaceship Earth. Then I'm gonna get off there and head on back to the, where am I gonna head back to? Let's see where I'm gonna head back to. I'm gonna head back to a resort on a bus. And then from there, I will go on a bus over back over to Disney Springs. So it hasn't been bad at all. And right now it's 6:30, quarter seven. And it's dark, so that means the sun's gone down. And it's a little bit cool, but it's not that bad. It's not that bad right now. And I just have a little t-shirt on, you know, a little t-shirt. But it's kind of quiet right here on this little walking path that you walk around to the monorail side to pick up to go to Epcot. So I'm gonna get over here and just wait for it. And then take a ride over there. I'm just hopping around and bouncing around and all because, like I say, I'm down here with my daughter, but she's on a doing the travel agent trip. She's down here with the some of the other agents and her roommate. They're actually over at Planet Hollywood right now eating supper and having a good time. She just sent me a video, and I watched that, and it was pretty cool. But I'm just hopping around, doing what I can do, and just continuing on with this vlog. And like I said, remember I told y'all that it was just my first time to get started doing this. And I'm enjoying doing it, but I want to get better at it, and it's going to take me some time to do it to get better at it. So, you know, I just want to just kind of try to talk to y'all a little bit and just tell you that things aren't always as bad as they seem, because as much as I hate to say it, we all have things that we deal with, the all things we're going through, but somebody's always got something worse than you. And I say that to myself, because I'm dealing with some things right now in my health, but I am in good enough health to be able to walk around, come to Disney World, and enjoy myself. And how would I say this? I know there's people that got things worse than I do. And I just try to allow the good Lord above to put my mind and heart in perspective about realizing that what I'm going through is not as bad as what some other people have. But there's a monorail going behind me right there. See, right there, a monorail. Yeah, but we just got to understand that we are all going through things differently than other people. But put your faith in God. So I'm gonna go catch this monorail, and then I'm gonna be heading on over. We're over here in the front of Epcot now, and I just wanted to stop over here. I just rode the monorail from the Ticket and Transportation Center over here to Epcot. And I met some good people here from Reading, which is just outside to the west side of London. Talked to them for a little while, very nice people. So I just wanted to stop by here. I'm gonna go catch a bus to a resort and then go back to Disney Springs. I'm gonna have to go do some things. But I just wanted to show y'all the spaceship Earth. I'm gonna be here tomorrow, and I'll do some more vlogs tomorrow here, and may have to run some of these into together, and it might also have to, that looks like a drone up there flying over. I don't know whose drone it is, but it's a drone.
It looks like it, don't it?
Uh-huh. Well, it's a drone, but anyway, we're about to catch a bus. I'm now over at Pop Century. I just decided to take a bus from Epcot over here to Pop Century. And then I'm gonna catch another bus and go on to Disney Springs. Have to wait for a few minutes for the bus, about 8:10. It's not too long a wait. And I'm surprised that with the sun down and it being dark, it's not really that cold out here at all. It's a little cool. It's not really chilly. It's just a little cool. I mean, I'm not shaking or shivering or anything. I'm not exactly sure what the temperature is out here right now, but it's cooler than it was earlier today. I think it got up between 65 and 70 today during the daytime. But bus is heading over to Magic Kingdom, I think it was. We got some bus coming here soon. But yeah, I'm just enjoying doing this and going around and videoing stuff, you know, and just having a good time, you know. So, but you know, I was gonna tell you that we stayed here at Pop Century three different times from the early 2000s into about the mid 2000s. And I liked it. I liked it. I liked it. But, you know, I can't afford the most expensive places, but I enjoyed this. So, anyway, just wanted to thought I'd touch in with y'all, and we're going to be heading back over soon. So, anyway, yeah, I know I'm repeating myself. We'll work it out. See you in a minute. Well, that's going to do it for this episode one for my Disney trip back in January with my daughter for her Disney trip with her travel agent company. I have episode two coming up, which will be my day at Epcot. I'm not sure exactly how long that video will be because I'm not sure how much I videoed there that day. But it'll be coming up soon, and then episode three will be coming up, which was Saturday, the day after I spent my day at Epcot, and this was going to be a day going resort hopping or just whatever I decided to do on Saturday. So stay tuned, and the Coolest Dad signing out.